Good morning. You're watching Senior Notebook on WENY.
Hi, welcome to Senior Notebook. My name is Candy Reed. I'm a member of the production team. And boy, do we have an exciting, exciting show for you today. I'm here with Tom and Betsy Gorman, who hiked the Appalachian Trail. Hi, folks. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Candy.
Hi, Candy.
Okay. Let's start, Tom and Betsy, talking. Well, I wanted to say that I read your story in the Big Flats newsletter. I couldn't stop reading. It's like a good book. I just couldn't put it down. I read the whole thing through. And every now and again, I saved it. And every now and again, I'll pick it up and I'll read it again. It's just an amazing, amazing, amazing story about your trek, really, on the Appalachian Trail. So tell us a little bit about the trail. Where does it begin? Where does it end?
The trail begins in Georgia, Spring Mountain, Georgia, and it goes all the way to Mount Katahdin in Maine.
Wow.
So it's 2,193 miles long.
Wow. And it traverses through how many states?
14 different states.
14 states. Wow. So tell us how you began. I know that you flew out of the Big Flats, Elmira Corning Airport.
We flew down to Atlanta, Georgia, and that was just when the COVID epidemic was coming on and things were really starting to shut down. Mm-hmm. And the airports were totally empty. Mm-hmm. And then when we got down to Atlanta, that was the first day that the restaurants were closed.
Oh.
And it was like a new adventure for us. Things were very, very quiet. So it was a very strange way to start our adventure.
To start this adventure.
Yeah.
So what's the trailhead, name of the trailhead where you started?
There's an approach trail before you get to the actual Appalachian Trail.
Okay.
And it starts at Amicalola Falls. And there's 600 steps that you have to climb from the bottom to the top of the falls. And
600 and
that's just the start of the approach trail.
Steps.
Yep. So just that was a little bit intimidating.
I used to think going up Watkins Glen steps was a horror.
That's what we did too. And so we practiced at Watkins Glen.
Uh-huh.
And that's only about a quarter of the steps when you get to the final steps at the end. That's about 100, okay. 150, I believe. So we said, well, we got to do that four times. And it wasn't really as bad as, because we had the adrenaline was flowing.
Yeah, yeah.
And before we knew it, we were up to the top.
So you got at the top, and what was the next feat?
Well, you had to finish the approach trail. So that's approximately 9 miles that doesn't count on the Appalachian Trail. So that puts you over 2,200 miles if you do the entire thing.
Okay.
So lots of people say, avoid the approach trail. Just ride up to, you can ride up almost to the top of Springer Mountain.
Yeah, but you wanted to do the whole
thing. We wanted to do the approach trail because that's part of the experience.
Yeah, yeah.
And so we hiked the 9 miles, and just before we got to the top of Springer Mountain in the beginning of the Appalachian Trail, it started to pour.
Oh.
And it rained and rained and rained. And
Did you find shelter?
Nope, we just kept hiking. And, and then when we got to the top of Springer Mountain, it was kind of like, here we are.
Yeah.
And so there's a little rock, and there's a book that's hidden underneath.
Okay.
And you sign your name in there, and it's kind of like a register.
Yeah, that you reached it.
Yeah. So that was the beginning of our adventure.
Okay.
And then we hiked down to our first shelter to spend the night.
Now you're still in Georgia, right?
Yes. Right. Yep. We're in Georgia for approximately 90 miles of the trail.
Yeah. Wow. So, Betsy, how did you survive the rain? I mean, you know, that's all wet clothing.
Honestly, I enjoyed the rain because even though it made it things a little bit slick and everything. But yeah. When you're hiking and you're carrying that load, you get hot, even if it's not real hot out.
Okay.
And the rain felt actually pretty good.
Yeah.
But when we got to the top, there were we were taking pictures and stuff. Yeah. There were a few other hikers, not as many as would normally be there, again, because of the whole COVID situation.
Right.
But everybody was there in ponchos. And
We have to break for a commercial right now, but we'll be right back with more information about this wonderful, wonderful hike.
Sounds good.
Senior Notebook will return in a moment. We now return to Senior Notebook on WENY.
Hi, we're back with Betsy and Tom Gorman talking about their Appalachian Trail event. You talked about, Betsy, about the rain, and you were kind of satisfied with it starting to rain.
Yes, yeah, because it actually kind of cools you down.
Yeah,
it wasn't bad, but then once we got to the shelter, the rain was then, we actually spent our first night, we were going to tent, but we spent it inside the shelter because we were worried about the rain.
Yeah.
And things cooled down and things were pretty wet at the shelter.
In the shelter, were there other folks there as well?
Yes.
Okay.
So so it was nice. They share stories and you hear, what they think of it and their adventures some fun conversation at the shelters.
Yeah. I'm interested in what goes into that backpack because, first of all, how much does that weigh?
Well, when I start out, when it's full with like 6 days worth of food and maybe an extra liter of water, it weighs close to 40 pounds.
Wow.
And what's in it is I carry the tent, I have a sleeping bag. The cook stove, we have the food for the 6 days, some extra clothes, some toiletries, have a cell phone, cell phone charger.
That's why it weighs 40 plus pounds.
And your water and water purification
you definitely need
system.
So in reading your story in the newsletter that you had to leave the trail due to COVID, can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, when I got to, just before I got to the Smoky Mountains, the trail was actually closed.
Okay.
And so I was waiting for the trail to open. It was supposed to reopen April 1st.
Okay.
And then April 1st came and they said, nope, there's no way the trail's going to reopen, not until at least March 15th, or May 15th,
Okay.
And so Betsy said, you got to come home.
Okay.
So I said, fine, please come down and get me. So she drove 12 hours down to down to pick me up in North Carolina.
Okay.
Yep. And so then I came back here and I was hiking on the local trails every day just to keep up my stamina.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so I did that until May 15th.
Okay.
And then they did reopen the trails.
And you started out
again. Yep. Betsy drove me back down because she had gotten off the trail after about 90 miles.
Okay.
It was just
hard on my feet, hard on my legs.
Reading that, I was thinking, my goodness, you're on tree stumps and stones and climbing up and descending down. It's like, wow.
Yeah, but she did a great job while she was out there, and I commend her for that.
And it was fun. It was fun. I'd like to try to do it again, but but it takes a little bit of.
I would imagine you love to walk. Because you've walked many trails in this area.
I've walked quite a few. Before I even started the Appalachian Trail, I logged 1,200 miles here on the local trails.
Mm-hmm.
And that was carrying my backpack. And just so that I was acclimated to hiking.
Exactly.
So I had already hiked half the Appalachian Trail as far as distance goes before I even started.
Yeah, right. So there was an interesting part of the story where you met up with a former hiker, I forgot his name, Smoke or something like that, who offered food for hikers.
Oh, okay. Yep, there's a former hiker, And his name is, his trail name is Fresh Ground. And,
Fresh Ground.
Yeah. And he actually formed a nonprofit, and he has a van, and he drives up and down the Appalachian Trail feeding through hikers. And he'll feed day hikers, he'll feed bikers, he doesn't care.
Wow.
And so when I reached the Shenandoahs, he teamed up with the group of hikers I was with, and he fed us for 5 days through the entire Shenandoahs. He fed us breakfast and he fed us dinner. What a treat that
was. I know, it must have been. I can't imagine. Fresh Ground, he was like a saint. We call him Saint Fresh Ground.
Yep, a trail angel.
Okay, we have to break here, and we'll be back with more interesting stories from the Gormans about their trip on the Appalachian Trail. Welcome back. I'm here with Betsy and Tom Gorman, and they're sharing some exciting stories about their hike on the Appalachian Trail. So you reach Harper's Ferry after traversing five states. So you're in Harper's Ferry, and then what?
Well, I'd gone 1,000 miles. Betsy came down to meet me there because it's a beautiful place. Mm-hmm. And so we had a kind of reunion for half a day. Mm-hmm. And walked through the town and went out to eat. And mm-hmm. I got resupplied, so I was ready to set out the next day. And I did start out the next day.
You did?
And I walked for about half an hour, and I was homesick.
Oh, that happens to the best of us.
So I called up Betsy on the phone, and I said, "Don't leave Harper's Ferry." And, "Are you still there?" And she said, yeah, I'm just packing up right now. And I said, "Wait for me, I'm coming back."
I'm coming home.
Yep. So
when you got back here to Big Flats?
When I got back to Big Flats, I set my pack in the corner, and I figured, well, it's going to sit there for a good long time. My hiking's over for a while. But 2-3 days later, I was back on the local trails.
Wow.
And within a week, I was asking Betsy, "Would you mind if I hike the long trail? It's only 273 miles. And that's in Vermont, and it's from the Massachusetts border all the way to Canada.
Wow.
So
what was that like?
That was kind of different. The first 105 miles, it runs right along with the Appalachian Trail, so you're on both trails.
Right.
And then when it splits and the long trail goes north, mm-hmm. The trail really changes in its personality.
Mm-hmm.
And it gets a lot more mountainous, and you're on ladders and rebar and climbing over this and that. It's kind of like rock climbing, So it wasn't something that I was really prepared for. But I made it through. And I did get scared at one point.
Okay.
I was going over kind of a cliffside, and I couldn't move forward because my backpack was too wide, and I didn't want to go back. So I had to take my backpack off, and I negotiated around the side of the rock face.
Wow.
But I was scared.
Wow.
Yeah. But I did finished the entire trail, and I made it all the way to Canada.
Wow.
And
that's amazing.
Betsy came and picked me up there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Betsy, you're wonderful.
Aw.
Yes, she is. To put up with me.
Yeah, but it was an adventure for both of us, because Tom was sending photos back every day. And so we have a Facebook page. It was called Gumby and Pokey on the AT. And he sent back just beautiful vistas and views and pictures of hostels where he stayed, and so I was able to post those on our Facebook page while I was sitting back home, and then our friends were able to kind of share in the adventure with him, so that was fun.
Yeah.
So even though I couldn't be with him in person, at least we were able to talk every day, and he was able to send me pictures. And
what a time. What a time in your life.
Yes.
What a time. What do you get out of this? I can imagine what you get out of it. Let's find out how you get out.
It's just an amazing adventure. You're out there, you're relying on yourself, and the vistas and that you see, they're just amazing. The only way you get to see them is if you're on the trail.
On the summit, yeah.
And it's just something that I'm really happy that I got to do, and I wouldn't give it up for anything.
Well, I'm happy for you. I'm happy that you did it as well. We all like to walk. I like to walk. I think it's interesting, but I get a little out of breath when I hike, so I can imagine what it was must have been like in Vermont on that trail. So, yeah.
It was an adventure.
Yeah. Thanks so much for joining us at Senior Notebook. What a wonderful, wonderful story. And the best in the future to you and Betsy, Tom.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thanks. You're welcome.